Hey y'all, Bill here, Metal Detecting RV'er. I just wanted to take a minute to tell you about a little RV trip that I just got back from. We took 5 days and went down to MacDill Air Force Base down in the Tampa-St. Pete, Florida area. And I've already put up a video on my Metal Detecting down there, just a short video, really didn't find anything, but I put that up. But I wanted to tell you about our little trip. Now, if you're new to RVing, some of this stuff may be new to you. If you're an experienced RV'er, then you'll understand what goes on. When you're RVing, you have to remember that whether you're full-time RVing or just on the road for a short period of time, this RV is like a house in a way. I mean, you live in it, so you've got all the expenses that you would if you lived in a brick and mortar house. You have to worry about the roof. You have to worry about the air conditioning. You have to worry about the water, your water fixtures, your hot water heater, your refrigerator, things like that that you'd normally have to worry about in a brick and mortar house. Plus, you have to worry about things like you have on your car, your vehicle. You have to worry about the engine air conditioning, the tires, the oil, fan belts, drivetrain, things like that. So really you've got a combination of both your regular house and your vehicle. So when you start off on a trip, keep that in the back of your mind that you're always going to have those things to consider. And just like your brick and mortar house or just like your car, there are going to be things that go wrong and you'll have to eventually fix them. So don't get upset and worried about them. They're going to happen. Anybody that's been RVing for a while knows that. If things are going to happen. New RVers, be aware, things are going to happen. Let me start out with the first thing that went wrong in our little trip. You can probably see over on my door here now, I've got a little plastic step up there because the regular steps, the day we went to leave, the steps would not retract. They would not come in. So we were about to leave on our trip, so what I had to do was jump out there, take a Carter key or a pair of pliers, pull out a Carter key, pull out a pin, and then push the steps back up under there and tie them up so we could go on our trip. And as you can tell, I still haven't had the opportunity to get them fixed yet. But that's the first thing. Day before we went on our trip, the engine air conditioning wasn't putting out cool air. And knowing we're going down to mid-Florida there and being hot, I wanted to get that charged up. So I took it down to a local shop and had them charge the air conditioning. Well, as it turns out, it was actually the compressor on the engine, just like a compressor air conditioning in your car, air conditioning on the engine, the compressor wasn't kicking on and off. So I was getting no cool air out of the engine air conditioner. So what I ended up doing was having to run the air conditioning, the roof air conditioners, and the generator the entire way down there. And which is, took us about, 8 hours. So I had 8 hours of generator runtime and then the roof air conditioners running, which kept it cool inside and we were okay. But I normally don't run the generator that long as we're going down the road. So we got out, got down there, got to MacDill. We were going through Tallahassee on I-10. And we hit a traffic jam. There was a wreck up there, an 18-wheeler, I don't know exactly what happened, but jammed up traffic. And we sat in a traffic jam for an hour in Tallahassee trying to get through. We just couldn't go anywhere. We were stuck on the interstate there. And since we were stuck for an hour, we ended up getting into MacDill late at night. First time we'd ever been there. And so it was dark by the time we got there. We finally got on post. We had to sign in and get on post and got to our site I had called them earlier saying that we were going to be late, and they said, just pick a site and then come in the morning and register and everything will be fine. So we did. But what I didn't realize was the mosquitoes were terrible down at MacDill in the campground. They've had so much rain down there that the mosquitoes were just terrible. I don't know, you can't tell it now, but I have probably 500 to 1,000 bites on my legs and arms and head. And, you know, mosquitoes love me. They just eat me up. And the funny part about it is I have a little personal anti-mosquito thing that I got, which supposedly puts a little umbrella of anti-mosquito scent around you. And I have completely forgot about it until the day we left down there that I had it. Otherwise, I would have used that and would have protected me. We travel with our little doggy, our little Yorkie, and so, of course, he's got to go out and go to the bathroom. So just taking him out to the bathroom for, you know, 10, 15 minutes at a time and then bringing him back in, I got ate up. I mean, I was just miserable. But that's only part of the story. While we were there, my charger, converter charger on the unit has gone out, and it was draining my 12-volt battery. We were plugged in and getting shore power, getting 110, but there's a lot of things in here that use 12-volt at the same time, and it was just draining it down. So we lost 12-volt power, which in turn was causing the, even though the air conditioners, the roof air conditioners on the unit are 110, the thermostats take 12 volts to operate. So they were kicking out, and I was getting, they weren't kicking, allowing the compressors to kick on, so I was getting warm air. So I had to go out and buy a charger, because I didn't have my old charger with me, so I could plug it in and charge it up. And once I got it charged back up and recycled the units, they were blowing out nice cool air, so we were okay. But again, that's just one of those things that are going to happen when you're RVing. Things are going to go wrong. We left there Monday morning and came on home, had a very uneventful trip. Fortunately, coming back home, everything went fine, and we're now here back at home, and I've got to do some work here getting a few things done. But I'm seriously considering leaving next week, going out to Texas and trading this Class A in on a Class C. People say, well, why would you do that? You know, you got a lot more room. Yeah, I've got a 37-foot Class A. It's got a lot of room in it. It's good to stay in. The problem I find is you've got to go at an RV park. It's very difficult to find a place to park or to boondock. Now, if I was out west, yeah, I could. There's a lot of places out there that are Bureau of Land Management, federal lands that you can boondock in for free, easy to get to, things like that that you can get into in this 37-foot without a problem. But there's a lot of places, or a lot of times when traveling, I'd like to just pull off the road and into a town and boondock on the side of the street for a place to stay for the night. Yeah, if there's a Walmart, you can pull into a Walmart with this thing, but you can't, it's very difficult to just find a place on the street to pull over and stop and boondock. In a Class C, I could do that. Another thing, a Class C, you've got less maintenance, is tires. The tire on this thing, it's a regular truck tire, and it will cost you $500 to $600 for a tire. Whereas on a Class C, you're probably looking at $200, $250 for a tire. So there's a big difference there. Not everybody can work on this Class A, especially this diesel pusher. The engine's in the back, it's under the bed, it's very difficult to get to. A lot of places will not work on them. Whereas a Class C, the engine and everything is right up front. It's just like a van or a one-ton pickup, ton and a half pickup. So it's a lot easier to work on, a lot cheaper to work on. Of course, you have these same problems with air conditioners on both, the water system on both, and things like that. So you're always going to have those problems. But I think maintenance on the Class C in the long run would be cheaper than on this diesel pusher. So I'm seriously looking at trading it in. Well, that's about it on the trip. We had a good time, other than mosquitoes. Were just eating me up, eating the wife up, eating the kids up. Didn't bother the dog, but it bothered all of us. But overall, had a good time metal detecting, even though I didn't find a lot. If you watch the metal detecting video, you'll see that. But I had a good time. It's good getting out. So, looking forward to doing more, but not right now. All right, that's about it. So until next time, happy RVing. Keep the greasy side down. Be safe. Good luck. Happy hunting on the metal detecting. And we'll see you later. Phil out.